जय हिंद। आई एम कैडेट प्रतीक पी कामत, रिप्रेजेंटिंग द कर्नाटका गोवा डायरेक्टरेट, 6 कर्नाटका एयर स्क्वाड्रन एनसीसी, मंगलोर। आई एम फ्रॉम एनसीसी एयर विंग फ्लाइट ए, एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द टॉपिक एयरक्राफ्ट रिकॉग्निशन। सो लेट अस बिगिन विद द प्रेजेंटेशन। एयरक्राफ्ट रिकॉग्निशन, ओके, सो व्हाई इज़ एयरक्राफ्ट रिकॉग्निशन यूजफुल? It is useful for both strategic and defense purposes. When it comes to military purpose, aircraft recognition is useful during both peace and wartime. Some individuals also take this up as a hobby. Next, we go through the various methods that are used to identify aircrafts. There are 6 main methods as listed here. We'll go through them one by one. First comes identification of aircraft by position of the wings and where they are placed. These are the 6 main methods to do this, and here are the images for each of these. As you can see here, this is the image for the high wing type of wing position. Here is the example for the shoulder wing, mid wing, this is the parasol wing, this is the low wing. Next comes identification of the aircraft by the shape of the wing. There are 9 main methods to do this. They are listed here, as you can see, and examples are over here. This is the backward taper. The equi taper, this is the delta shaped wing, and this is the crescent. You can see there is an example for swept forward over here. Here is one for biplane and monoplane over here, and this is dihedral. One of the main methods of identification of aircraft is by identifying the shape of the wing tip. The end of the wing is known as a wing tip. Winglets are the vertical extensions of this wing tip. So there are 4 types of wing tips, mainly circular, tapered, pointed, and squared. We can also identify the aircraft by observing the shape of the canopy. Here we can see a few types of canopy. There's a list of shapes of canopy over here, and there are examples for each. This is this one is inline, this is submerged, this is glass house type of canopy, and this is bubble. Identification of an aircraft by its shape of fin and tailplane. So here are a few examples for the different shapes of fin and tailplane. There are 5 listed over here, and here are a few examples for them. This is low mounted on tail is the same as low tailplane. This is mid tailplane, and this is high tailplane. Another way for aircraft identification is by its markings. So as you can see, this is the roundel of India. You might have seen these markings on aircrafts, Indian Air Force aircrafts. Here is an example. You can see this is the MiG-21 Bison. There are markings over here, as you can see, on the wings and on the tail. To identify the aircrafts of enemy origin or foreign origin, it is important for us to know their markings too. So this is the roundel of Pakistan, our neighboring country, and here is their flag. We'll now move on to the next part of the presentation, that is identification of Indian as well as foreign aircrafts. So here we'll go through the different aircrafts in IAF fleet, like IAF fighter aircraft fleet, IAF transport aircraft fleet, the helicopter fleet, the trainer aircraft fleet, the aircrafts that were and are made in India, and foreign aircrafts. We'll first go through the different aircrafts present in the IAF's fighter aircraft inventory. Here we can see seven different types of aircrafts listed that are present in the fighter aircraft fleet. So, Sukhoi Su-30 MKI. It was induced into IAF in 2002. It was designed by Sukhoi Corporation and built under license by HAL or Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. Its design is derived from Sukhoi Su-27, an older version of this. Mirage 2000 was deployed for Operation Safed Sagar with its first sortie on 30th May 1999 during Kargil War. It was considered a game changer. MiG-29. These aircrafts were used extensively during the 1999 Kargil War in Kashmir by IAF to provide fighter escort for the Mirage 2000s attacking their targets with laser-guided bombs. MiG-27. Since 2001, the IAF has lost more than 12 MiG-27s to crashes. So, in mid-February 2010, India had grounded its entire fleet of over 150 aircrafts. It was later decommissioned on 27th of December 2019. MiG-21 Bison. It was used during the Vietnam War by the Soviets. It is also called by an infamous name, the Flying Coffin, due to the large number of accidents and deaths it has caused. Sepikat Jaguar. This aircraft is still in service with the IAF. It is a twin engine single-seater deep penetration strike aircraft which has maximum speed of 1350 km per hour or Mach 1.3. Dassault Rafale. It is referred to as an omni-role aircraft by Dassault Systems. As of now, the IAF has acquired about 26 of these aircraft out of the 36 units ordered. We'll now move on to the next topic, that is different transport aircrafts in the IAF. So here are 8 of them listed. We'll go through them one by one. C-130J. It is equipped with an infrared detection set or IDS. The aircraft can perform precision low level flying, airdrops and landing in blackout conditions. The first C-17 was delivered in January 2013 for testing and training. Recently, the IAF Boeing C-17 Globemaster has airlifted 35 tons of COVID medical supplies from Frankfurt, Germany. This load was flown to Mumbai on May 11, 2021. IL-76. It was first planned as a commercial freighter in 1967 as a replacement for the Antonov An-12. IAF's IL-76 has been used in transporting cryogenic oxygen containers, just like C-17 Globemaster. Antonov An-32. It is a turboprop twin-engine military transport aircraft. It is of Russian origin. Embraer. This image here is the aircraft used by DRDO for AEW and CS or Airborne Early Warning and Control System. Avro. It is a turboprop aircraft designed and produced by the British aircraft manufacturer Avro. Dornier. It is a highly versatile multi-purpose light transport aircraft. It's used as a commuter transport, third level services, and also for air taxi operations. Boeing 737-200. It is used as a VIP passenger aircraft. It is produced by the American aircraft manufacturing company Boeing. Now we'll look into a few helicopters present in the IAF inventory. MI-25 or MI-35. It is a large helicopter gunship, attack helicopter, and low capacity troop transport. So it is multi-purpose. AH-64 Apache. It is armed with a 30mm chain gun. It is fitted with a pylon that carries Hellfire missiles and Hydra 70 rocket pods. The IAF currently has about 22 Apache helicopters in their inventory. This is an image of Apache helicopter. Next, MI-17 V5. It was used during Operation Safed Sagar in the first air phase of Kargil War. After one aircraft was downed by the enemy, attacks by the fixed winged aircraft began. Chetak. It is a French helicopter and is used by the IAF for various purposes. As you can see here, it is suitable for commuting or cargo material transport, casualty evacuation, search and rescue, and it is multi-purpose. IAF Cheetah. It has been a backbone in search and rescue operations, casualty evacuation, and route transport role in the IAF. Cheetah is similar to IAF Chetak with respect to its origin being French and a few of its uses, but its size is comparatively smaller than Chetak, and also its sling loads are lower than Chetak. MI-26. This aircraft has been used in several rescue operations, mainly search and rescue operations. It was mainly used during the Chernobyl nuclear incident by the Soviets. Next, we'll move on to the IAF trainer aircraft fleet. There are four of them listed here. We'll go through them one by one. IAF Kiran. It's designed and manufactured by HAL or Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. It's used as an aerobatic aircraft by the Surya Kiran team during the Aero India shows. Hawk. It is a British origin single engine jet powered aircraft designed by BAE Systems. It is an advanced jet trainer aircraft for pilots. Pilatus PC-7. It is a light trainer aircraft developed by the Swiss aircraft manufacturer Pilatus. It is also used as an aerobatic aircraft. It is also a turbo trainer. Pipistrel Virus SW-80. Here the SW stands for short wing. This aircraft is used for recreational purposes by private individuals. But in the IAF, it is used by NCC cadets. Mainly, it is used to give NCC air wing cadets a taste for flying. So now we'll go through a list of aircrafts that are of Indian origin. LCA Tejas. It is a single engine aircraft expected to be supersonic at all altitudes. Its small size reduces its chance of detection by enemy radars. They are also capable of short takeoff and landings. LCH, or Light Combat Helicopter. It is a twin-seater light combat helicopter with four hardpoints and provisions to carry rockets, missiles, and bombs. It is developed by HAL and is Indian. HAL Dhruv. It has a top speed of 295 km per hour and has a service ceiling of about 6,069 meters or 20,000 feet. Let us now look at a few foreign aircrafts, mainly our neighboring country, Pakistan's aircrafts. First, we'll look into Sikorsky S-61 or Sea King. This is Pakistan Air Force military helicopter Sikorsky S-61. It is also one of the most widely used airliner and oil rig support helicopters ever built. MiG-19. It is a Soviet second generation single seater twin jet fighter aircraft. The version of aircraft that the PAF has is of Chinese origin, also called Shenyang J-7. Mirage 5. It has two 30mm DEFA channels with 125 rounds per gun and 7 external ordnance stations. The aircraft is of French origin, produced by Dassault Systems. C-130 Hercules. It is capable of using unprepared runways for takeoffs and landings. Its features are similar to that of the Boeing C-130J Hercules that the IAF has. So now let us recap and go through all the topics we covered under aircraft recognition. First, we went through the usefulness of aircraft recognition. What are its uses? We went through how it helps us during wartime and peacetime. Those were the main points. Then we covered all the different methods of identifying aircraft and all the different parts like the wings, the wing tips. First we went through the wing position, then the wing shape, then the shape of wing tips, then the shape of the canopy, and then we went over the shape of fins and tailplane, then over the markings. Then we identified the different types of Indian and foreign aircrafts. We saw all the aircrafts under the IAF fighter aircraft fleet, the IAF transport aircraft fleet, the IAF helicopter fleet, the IAF trainer aircraft fleet, the aircrafts that were made in India or produced in India, and a few foreign aircraft fleet. So we've almost come to the end of this lecture. To conclude, aircraft recognition is an integral part of a nation's defense and military. Aircraft recognition is extremely important and vital for a person when it comes to being an IAF officer. Recognizing and identifying aircraft is extremely useful and an important skill an air wing cadet must learn. Thank you and Jai Hind.